All this debris is what's left when the river that runs through the town rose and chewed away the road. This road is back open now, but many more are still impassable. The damage was to public and private infrastructure. Long morning for you.
Very long.
Al Ouellette was one of countless Vermonters who feared for their safety Sunday night. He evacuated his home in Stowe voluntarily. After water from what's being called the state's most catastrophic flooding ever gushed into his newly renovated basement, more than 6 feet of it.
And the water was this deep in here.
The state office complex in Waterbury was swamped too, and that forced a government shutdown of non-emergency personnel. The National Guard helped save computer equipment from the Human Services Agency, hoping to ensure Vermonters can keep getting the help they need. Fire departments were busy inspecting flooded properties. Most of this downtown strip was still without power Monday afternoon, and the first responders didn't want to flip the switch until they knew the electrical systems were safe.
There could be fuel oil in these basements, which is quite a concern. We don't want to energize a building and start a fire.
Back at Al Ouellette's, the homeowner is like most Vermonters. He doesn't have flood insurance. It's estimated less than a fifth of residents in flood zones have the policies, which are often pricey.
We're trying to track down FEMA guys, and hopefully that'll cover it. Otherwise, I don't know what we're going to do.